To register for classes, you'll need to log into your ctcLink account. There are a few ways to log into ctcLink, but the easiest is to go through the My SPSEC landing page, which houses most of the helpful links you'll need as a student. You can access this page by heading to the main spsec.edu page, selecting the menu icon in the top right corner, and then choosing My SPSEC. From there, choose the first option for ctcLink login. You'll enter in your ctcLink number and password to get logged in. Once you're in your account, you'll want to navigate to the Class Information section and then choose Class Search. Here, you'll be able to use different search filters to locate the classes you want to add to your schedule. Make sure that the term field is set to the correct quarter. If you know the exact course you would like to add, you can use these next two fields, Academic Organization and Catalog Number. Say you're looking to add CCS 101. The Academic Organization field lists each department, so we'll scroll down to College and Career Success Department. You can also start typing CCS in the field to narrow down your search. Then we'll type in the course number into the catalog field. Selecting Search Now gives us every section of CCS 101 that is being offered that quarter. These are all the same course, just different classrooms of students that meet in different rooms, times, etc. Let's take a look at these search results. The rightmost column lets you know the course's mode of instruction. At SPSEC, courses are offered in person, online, or as hybrid courses. The days column will let you know what days of the week a course is meeting, and then the start and end columns will let you know when during those days those courses will meet. It's important to note that sometimes even online courses will have meeting times listed. These courses meet online via a virtual conferencing software like Zoom or Teams. If a course has no days or times listed and it's showing as online, that means it's a fully online course. Hybrid courses may only meet once or twice a week, with the rest of the coursework being online. But let's say that you want to choose only those courses that are on campus. This is when we'll utilize the instruction mode filter, so we'll choose in person and hit search again. When we look at these results, we'll obviously want to pay attention to the days and times to ensure that they work with the schedule that you're hoping to have. You'll also want to carefully look at the room column. The rooms that are listed with a B in front are located on our main Olympia campus on Mottman Road. If you see an L, that's our Lacey campus. ABC would be our Angela Bowen Center, and then CBD would be our craft brewing and distilling facility. Now, you may notice that some of the courses that you're looking at could be full when you go to register for them. You can tell by the color. Let's look at some examples for a psychology class. If a course has a green O, that means it's open and it has seats available. If you see that a course has a red-orange W and a purple O, that means that the course is full, no seats are available, and that the waitlist has now been activated. As seats become available in a course, say if a student changes their mind and drops it, the waitlist will automatically enroll the first student on the list. These numbers are an indication of what's available. Here, it's saying that 21 out of 28 seats are available. Here, there are 10 out of 28 seats open. In this one, there are 0 out of 28 seats available. The waitlist is on, and for the waitlist, there are 24 spots available out of 30, which means that there are 6 people on the waitlist already. If we were to add ourselves to the waitlist for that section, we would be number 7 on the list. Once you've determined the course that you'd like to add, you can enroll in it by selecting it. This will expand it open so that you can read all of its information. You know, things like the course description, its location, its requirements or prerequisites, placement levels, etc. If you're sure about the class and want to add it without delay, you'll select the blue Enroll button directly from the search. When you choose that, you'll get a pop-up that asks for a permission number. We don't use permission numbers here, so you can just select Save. And you'll get a confirmation that the course has been added to your schedule. That will happen if you're eligible to take the course. Now, if you don't see a blue Enroll button in the course when you expand it open, it might mean that your account login was unsuccessful. So go ahead, log in again, try to enroll again, and then should work. Now, let's say that you're not sure about a course. You're not ready to add it in that moment, but you want to save it as an option. You can add it to what's known as your shopping cart by selecting this Add to Cart button and then hitting Save to add it to your cart. You'll see this blue shopping cart icon to confirm that it's been saved. And just like any online shopping experience, you need to make sure to go back to your shopping cart when you're finished searching to check out and fully enroll in the course. So you'll select the enrollment tab here on the left, then shopping cart. You'll see your choices in the shopping cart here. To enroll in the course, you would select the checkbox and then hit enroll. To add yourself to the waitlist of a course, you'll do the same enrollment action, choosing a course, hitting enroll, but instead you'll check this box that says waitlist if class is full before selecting save. There's your confirmation and your position on the waitlist. To see your schedule, you can select the schedule tab here on the left. This brings up a calendar view. To switch to a list view, you'll select the list icon here at the top and it'll switch over. Remember, if you have any questions about the courses you need to take for your program of study, please get in touch with your educational and career planner, come to the Advising Career and Transfer Center's regular advising walk-in hours, or email advising@spscc.edu. Happy registering!